Right now at noon, a mill fire in Woonsocket now causing concerns over air quality and water.
Ready?
Yeah, it's we're ready. It's been a long wait, 2.5 years.
And a family says they're now closer to justice as the trial for a deadly hit and run gets underway. Plus, breaking international news, a major incident reported in the United Kingdom. What we're learning from local police there, your ABC 6 News at Noon starts right now.
This is Southern New England's trusted news source, ABC 6 News at Noon.
Right now in Woonsocket, an investigation continues following a massive fire at an abandoned mill on Privilege Street. Good afternoon and thanks for joining us. I'm Caitlin Gelhouse. According to our reporter on scene, emergency crews are starting to take down some of the additional hoses and lines. Nearly all of the fire is handled as crews deal with hot spots. ABC 6 News reporter Josh Kerman brings us a look at what's left and how the community is reacting.
These plumes of off-colored smoke are all that's left from a fire that turned a multi-acre chemical mill into a pile of rubble.
I figured they were going to tear it down, but I didn't expect it to be a fire, no.
Crews got a call around midnight for a structure fire on Privilege Road, the site of an abandoned chemical mill that's been top of mind for staff for years.
Yeah, so our concern was just it being such a large structure with the chemicals that were in here before and being empty now, that the possibility is always there that it could lead to a fire at some point. Yeah, all the big buildings are a concern to us, especially the uninhabited ones.
Cahill says in the past few weeks they've had DEM and police clear out the chemicals that have been left in the building and people who are staying inside. He also says they believe the odd color of the smoke is from the roofing material, but they did have hazmat on scene just to be sure.
Where I used to work, we used to get our chemicals from there. But I'm not too concerned about it because I think it was pretty well cleaned out. I think the rain's got to keep it under control, which helps.
Yeah, very, because my child's right around the corner. Really? So hopefully it's nothing too contagious or harmful.
Initially, power was shut down in the area, but crews were able to restore it to nearby homes Monday morning. And crews remained on scene to check for any hotspots. The chief tells me there are no injuries from this fire. Looking forward, the fire marshal is finishing up its inspection of the actual scene before they'll work on clearing out some of the debris from the roadway just in front of the building. After that, they'll work on a crew to get out there to take down the rest of the structure. In Woonsocket, Josh Kerman, ABC 6 News.
Thanks, Josh. And due to the mill fire, the Woonsocket Water Division says some residents may have discolored water. Take a look at this photo shared with us from Jeanette, who lives in the area. Jeanette says this was the color of their water from the sink this morning. The Water Division is asking everyone in the area to refrain from using water for several hours to let the sediment settle. The division is recommending to use an outside spigot to flush your lines and avoid using hot water to stop sediment from being drawn into your tank. Thanks. And viewers are also sharing what they saw overnight. These photos of the smoke were sent in by Lucas. They were far from the flames, but you can see the smoke was still seen billowing into the sky. We're still waiting to hear back from the Department of Environmental Management on air quality concerns or environmental impact. We'll keep you updated as we learn more on air, online, and on our Now Local News app. And the Woonsocket City Council also responding to the fire in a statement saying, quote, "It is sad to see such a large structure lost to fire, and I commend all of the firefighters who worked to contain the fire and protect the neighboring properties. I'm relieved to see that there were no injuries." And breaking international news, at least 8 people are hospitalized with stab wounds following a major incident in the United Kingdom. Officers responded just before noon local time to reports of a stabbing at a property on Hart Street in Southport, a seaside town just about 20 miles north of Liverpool. Now, according to officials, police have detained a man and taken a knife. He's been taken to a police station. And our favorite time, turning now to the forecast. Gray skies, wet weather out there to start the work week. It's pretty foggy out there. Let's get a check-in with our ABC6 storm tracker meteorologist, Ceci Del Carmen. She's going to fill us in on everything we need to know. Or do we need an umbrella all day, Ceci? I hope not.
You know what? I think we need to keep it. I actually keep one year-round in my car. Just have to remember to take it out when it is raining out there. So it is a great day out there, and it is a dreary start to the work weekend. You know, we were talking about thunderstorm activity this morning. Well, there they are. They're over central and eastern parts of Long Island. We're seeing those strikes right there. Wherever you see the brighter colors, the yellows, the oranges, the red, especially, that's where you would be seeing all of this activity take place. And Caitlin was talking about fog. Well, the visibility is down to 2.5 miles at the airport, as well as New Bedford, down to 2 miles in North Kingstown. We're also dealing with a high surf advisory since this morning. Large breaking waves along the Massachusetts coast, dangerous rip currents. And that will be in effect until 6 this evening. We're going to see these conditions improve. It is going to quiet down overnight tonight. And tomorrow we could even see some sunshine. In the meantime, we have to deal with this light rain, with the fog, with the mist, and these temperatures cooler than average. We'll only be topping out approximately 10 degrees below average. All those details ahead. Caitlin?
Everybody's ready to see justice served.
After more than 2 years, the trial in a January 2022 traffic death is underway. 17-year-old Olivia Passeretti was killed in a hit and run on I-95 South in Warwick, New Year's Day of 2022. Alicia Peckham faces multiple charges, including leaving the scene of an accident with death resulting and harboring a criminal after allegedly picking up her boyfriend, Aramis Segura, in East Greenwich after the crash. Olivia's family was at the Kent County Superior Court, and they spoke with ABC6 ahead of the trial today.
You know, two years, 8 months ago, these people took my whole world and destroyed a family. It's time. We're ready. Nothing brings her back. Nothing.
And this is only part one.
You know, we still are waiting for the monster that drove her off the road at 100 miles an hour. His trial should be coming.
Now, Peckham and Segura have both pled not guilty. And right now in Massachusetts, a Stoughton man is being remembered after he was hit and killed on Route 24 while picking up debris. Plymouth District Attorney Tim Cruz identified the Department of Transportation worker as David Souza. Stoughton Police Chief Donna McNamara posted a statement on the passing of Souza, saying David Spanky Souza was a lifelong Stoughton resident and a longtime friend. Souza was known for playing Santa Claus every year. Stoughton firefighters also sharing a statement on his passing, saying our thoughts and prayers go out to his family and friends. We offer our sincerest condolences. Spanky has truly left his mark not only on our department, but on the entire town of Stoughton, and he'll be missed by us all. And the driver who allegedly hit Souza remained on scene and is cooperating with police. The investigation is ongoing. In Warwick, a man who had his life saved by the Warwick Fire Department is now saying a big thank you. Back on May 9th, the man's heart went into cardiac arrest, but was brought back to life by 8 firefighters. That man and his family are now saying thank you to the department at their headquarters on Veterans Memorial Drive. We'll have that full story for you coming up on your ABC6 News at 4. Still to come on ABC6 News at noon. We're less than 100 days out from the presidential election, and President Joe Biden is taking on a new issue that could be the center of debate for both parties. And wildfires continue to burn in California, where it stands this afternoon in the efforts to extinguish it.
Got another one. And another one. That's the sound of more happy clients at Bataro Injury Lawyers. Great reviews like these don't happen by accident. After a car crash, we work hard to get our clients great results. But don't just listen to us. Listen to the thousands of people we've helped. If you've been injured, you want 5-star results, and that's what you'll get when you call us. It's good to know Mike Bataro. 777-7777.
On better sleep at Raymour & Flanigan today.
Get hundreds off top mattress brands, up to $300 off Serta, up to $500 off Avocado, and up to 40% off Nectar. Get the mattress of your dreams and sleep better for as little as $28 per month with no deposit and no interest for 72 months. Mattresses are in stock and ready for free next day delivery. Plus, we'll remove and recycle your old mattress. Don't wait. Better sleep starts now at Ray Moore and Flanagan.
How do you print money legally? Just own an insurance company. They get a payment every month. But if you get injured, they argue about paying you. At Rob Levine & Associates, we use the power of law to get you more than the insurance company wants to pay. Call the heavy hitter.
Call 1-800-LAW-1222.
ABC 6 Weather with Ceci Del Carmen. Brought to you by the Preserve Sporting Club and Resort.
Welcome back, everybody. Thank you for joining us. We are with gray skies out there dealing with some shower activity and also thunderstorms already firing up over central and eastern parts of Long Island. And we are definitely giving that air conditioner a break today because these temperatures on the cool side, but the heat and humidity is incoming as we head into the latter part of the work week. 64 in Providence at the moment, that wind out of the west-southwest. Current temperatures across the board in the 60s, flirting with 70 in Boston, 69 in Chatham, 70 Nantucket, and 67 Martha's Vineyard, mid to upper 60s across our state. And the dew point for today, expecting to make it into and around 67. At the moment, this is what we're seeing. We're seeing that swirl right there, allowing all of that moisture from the ocean. And notice those lightning bolts over eastern parts of Long Island. We could be seeing a little bit of that as well. Visibility having a tough time, especially across the airport down into North Kingstown, down to 3 miles, down to 5 miles in Smithfield, and less visibility over northeastern parts of Connecticut. Conditions will be improving as we head into late day today, overnight into tomorrow. Tomorrow we could see some sunshine and also the cloud cover promising to stick around as well. But we're also not ruling out the threat for a stray shower. Now, in the meantime, as we head into Wednesday, that will pick up once again. We should expect another possibility for unsettled weather. And then on Thursday, conditions will improve. The temperatures will head into and around that 90-degree mark. In the meantime, right now, gray skies. And notice this. Oh, could we see a little bit of sunshine? Well, maybe. Mid-70s today, running approximately 10 degrees below average. Heat and humidity is back as we head into Thursday with plenty of sunshine. Summer is still here. Let's enjoy it while it lasts. We'll be back.
With so much at stake, more Americans turn to ABC's World News Tonight with David Muir, America's number one newscast across all of television.
And ABC 6 News with Tiffany Murphy and John DeLuca, Southern New England's trusted news team.
Get ready to be cool all summer. Go with Petro. For an expert AC system tune-up, go with Petro. Fast AC repairs? Energy-efficient new AC? Go with Petro. For everything you need to stay cool and save this summer, go with your local HVAC pros. Go with Petro. Call Petro Home Services today for special offers.
Steve, we need to celebrate the couch potato in all of us.
Join us and be a couch potato too.
Wow, I'm a couch potato.
Only at Modern Furniture in Fall River.
You've been served.
What are you gonna do when Christina tries to take our baby?
He's gonna have a total meltdown.
Bring you out!
There was an accident.
Somebody help her!
General Hospital on ABC.
As the fire of love grows,
I am falling.
I'm falling for you.
An old flame could burn it all down.
What is going on?
I can't do this.
New Bachelorette, tonight on ABC.
Man, I'm so excited right now. The greatest group of all time. Name a musical instrument that might give you when you go to hell.
Bagpipes.
Celebrity Family Feud, new Tuesday on ABC.
Here's your chance to let the world know your vibe. It's the ABC 6 Wright's Dairy Farm Viewer Spotlight page, a question a day where you can vote your vibe to the top. Like, where is Rhode Island's best beach? Who makes the tastiest New England clam chowder? It's a fun and easy way to let the world know just how you feel. Go to the ABC 6 Viewer Spotlight page and vote your vibe.
And now to your Voice Your Vote 2024. President Biden is calling for major reforms to the Supreme Court. It includes term limits, a code of conduct, and limits presidential immunity. It comes as we are less than 100 days away from Election Day, with the race for the White House continuing to take shape. ABC's Perry Russum is in Washington with more.
In a Washington Post op-ed this morning, President Biden proposing major changes to the Supreme Court and a constitutional amendment on presidential immunity. Biden says he wants to limit the broad presidential immunity established in the landmark ruling from the High Court earlier this month. Biden writing, "It would make clear that there is no immunity for crimes a former president committed while in office." He's also proposing term limits for the justices, where a president would appoint a justice every 2 years and the justice would spend 18 years on the High Court. Biden writes, "It would reduce the chance that any single presidency radically alters the makeup of the court for generations to come." And Biden is calling for a Supreme Court code of conduct. He says the current ethics code is weak and self-enforced. Vice President Kamala Harris endorsing the proposal as she sees a boost in favorability.
"We have a fight ahead of us."
New polling from ABC News and Ipsos shows Harris now has a favorability of 43%, up from 35% before Biden dropped out of the race. Former President Trump's favorability has dropped. The same poll shows he's now at 36%, down from 40% after the Republican National Convention and assassination attempt. Trump attacking Harris over the weekend.
"A Kamala Harris presidency means 4 more years of extremism, weakness, failure, chaos, and probably World War III.
Biden will be talking about his proposals this afternoon in Austin, Texas, at the LBJ Presidential Library, where he also will be marking the 60th anniversary of the Civil Rights Act. Perry Russum, ABC News, Washington.
And right now in New Jersey, police are investigating after police say an officer shot and killed a woman in her home. The woman was shot in the chest after she reportedly charged at them with a knife in the hallway of her Fort Lee apartment early Sunday. Just before 1:30 in the morning, officers were responding to a 911 call about the woman having a mental health crisis holding a knife. The woman was taken to the hospital where she was pronounced dead. Dozens of Rhode Islanders joined together on the State House steps yesterday, holding a vigil for Sonia Massey. Vigils just like this one in the capital city took place all across the nation over the weekend. The 36-year-old mother was gunned down and killed by a police officer. She called 911 for help, saying she thought there was a prowler outside her home in Springfield, Illinois. The officer that shot her has been fired and is now behind bars, charged with homicide. Police body camera footage released this week shows Massey asking the officers not to hurt her before the shots rang out. In Providence, Black Lives Matter RIPAC lit candles and brought flowers to honor Massey.
"People are dying at the hands of the people that are here supposed to serve us and protect us, and they're killing us. Systemically across our country, people are losing their lives, and this is not acceptable. I don't know what it's going to take to change. Yes, we're coming out now, but when the newness of this particular situation goes away, where are we going to be? Are we going to stand and continue to fight 1 week right after another, or are we going to just sit around and continue to wait for the next one to happen?"
And activists are demanding justice for the mother of two, calling for police reform at the federal level. A massive wildfire dubbed the Park Fire is raging out of control in Northern California, becoming the 7th largest fire in the state's history. Authorities have arrested a 42-year-old man, accusing him of sparking this massive blaze by pushing a burning car down a gully. The county DA says Ronnie Dean Stout II is being held without bail. He's likely to face an arson charge, but it's unclear what count. The DA's office says the court also is set to assign him a public defender at the hearing. More than 350,000 acres have been burned. That is an area larger than cities such as Los Angeles or Phoenix. 4 counties are under evacuation orders or warnings, and despite efforts, containment is at 10%. California Governor Gavin Newsom has declared a state of emergency for Pluma's and for several counties, and President Joe Biden is closely monitoring the situation and has ordered his administration to provide maximum support. to firefighters. Still to come on ABC 6 News at noon, the investigation into the assassination attempt of Donald Trump continues. What we're learning from an interview with the local SWAT team who was there.
Ricky, after school you have to clean your room. Angie, do the laundry. Honey, please remember to take out the trash.
Mom, I have dance. I have baseball.
I can't do everything around here. Saturday, everyone is staying home to clean this house.
We can't do it Saturday. We're going to my mother's.
Who has time to clean? Call Just the Basics Cleaning Service. Just the Basics will wash your floors on their hands and knees, scrub the bathroom and kitchen, change your beds, relax. Call Just the Basics. Gift certificates available for all occasions.
The itch and rash of moderate to severe eczema disrupts my skin night and day. Despite treatment, it's still not under control. But now I have Rinvoq. Rinvoq is a once-daily pill that reduces the itch and helps clear the rash of eczema fast. Some Rinvoq patients felt significant itch relief as early as 2 days. Some achieved dramatic skin clearance as early as 2 weeks. And many taking Rinvoq saw clear or almost clear skin.
Rinvoq can lower your ability to fight infections, including TB. Serious infections and blood clots, some fatal. Cancers, including lymphoma and skin. Heart attack, stroke, and GI tears occurred. People 50 and older with a heart disease risk factor have an increased risk of death. Serious allergic reactions can occur. Tell your doctor if you are or may become pregnant.
Help heal your painful skin. Disrupt the itch and rash of eczema. Talk to your doctor about Rinvoq.
Learn how AbbVie can help you save.
Why wait, Massachusetts? Shop now and seize the summer. At Raymour & Flanigan, you can save up to 20% across the store. Shop online and in-store today and save more than twice the Massachusetts sales tax. Take advantage of financing options that fit your budget with no-interest financing for up to 72 months with equal payments. Why wait? Quality furniture, in stock, and delivered to your home in 3 days or less. Hurry in. Save double the tax now at Raymour & Flanigan.
We're learning more about the failure to stop the assassination attempt of former President Donald Trump at a rally in Pennsylvania. For the first time, members of the local SWAT team that played a key role in protecting him is speaking exclusively with ABC News. ABC's Rena Roy has more on what they're saying.
In their first public comments, members of the Beaver County SWAT team speaking exclusively with ABC News, describing what they say were planning and communication failures surrounding the assassination attempt of former President Donald Trump. That shooting killed a local firefighter and severely injured two others at a campaign rally in Butler, Pennsylvania earlier this month. The SWAT team says they noticed the suspect, Thomas Matthew Crooks, nearly 2 hours before the shooting, and something seemed off. At 4:26 p.m., one of the snipers texted, "You see me go out with my rifle, so he knows you guys are up there." By 5:14 p.m., they grew suspicious.
He was looking up and down the building and just wandering around, and it just seemed out of place.
Greg Nickel says he snapped these photos of the shooter and shared them in a group text to local snipers on the scene.
I assumed that there would be somebody coming out to, speak with this individual.
We have to assume that when he put that information out to command, that command took that information and did something with it.
It's unclear if their concerns reached members of Trump's Secret Service detail. The Washington Post reports the agents complained they were not made aware of the warnings.
We were supposed to get a face-to-face briefing with the Secret Service snipers whenever they arrived, and that never happened. So I think that was probably a pivotal point where I started thinking things were wrong, because that never happened, and we had no communication with the Secret Service.
The Secret Service declined to respond directly, but tells ABC News it's committed to better understanding what happened and is offering complete cooperation with ongoing investigations.
Members of the SWAT team believe they did everything they could to prevent the attack, but accept their share of responsibility. They add they're studying footage of the site because former President Trump plans to hold another rally in western Pennsylvania soon. Rena Roy, ABC News, New York.
How fast can you open a new personal checking account at Washington Trust? Faster than waiting for the perfect wave. Open your personal checking account in around 5 minutes. Switch all your direct deposits and auto pay securely with just a few clicks. And when you sign up for direct deposit, get $200. Take the fast, easy way to better banking. Switch your personal checking to Washington Trust. What we value is you.
Selling homes is more than a way to fill the workday. It's a sanctuary, a reflection of dreams, and a testament to hard work. Selling homes, it's where we create real memories. It's where we find real comfort and peace. It's where we find real meaning.
Imagine a sectional with endless configurations for only $250 a section. Now you don't have to imagine, thanks to my brand new Modular Bob.
Ooh, I've seen these.
Not like this, you haven't. It slices. It dices. Take a look at this. And that. The console is powered up to charge all your devices. With 5 unique pieces and infinite configurations, we can do this all day.
All day.
Oh my Bob!
Bob's Discount Furniture.
Hi, my name is Damian Clark. If you have both Medicare and Medicaid, I have some really encouraging news that you'll definitely want to hear. Depending on the plans available in your area, you may be eligible to get extra benefits with the Humana Medicare Advantage Dual Eligible Special Needs Plan. All these plans include a Healthy Options Allowance, a monthly allowance to help pay for eligible groceries, utilities, rent, and over-the-counter items. The Healthy Options Allowance is loaded onto a prepaid card each month, and whatever you don't spend carries over from each month. Other benefits on these plans include free rides to and from your medical appointments, and our large networks of doctors, hospitals, and pharmacies. So call the number on your screen now and ask about a Humana Medicare Advantage Dual Eligible Special Needs Plan. Humana, a more human way to healthcare.
Well, Ceci, not the prettiest of Mondays out there to start the work week for people. What can we expect the rest of the day? Light drizzle out there in Providence right now, but you mentioned some other parts are getting these heavy downpours.
Yes, some other areas are getting those downpours. We could be seeing quite an improvement overnight tonight. And on top of that, we're dealing with these temperatures cooler than average, running 10 degrees cooler. And then tomorrow, a little bit of a lull, but then it all comes back as we head into Wednesday. Heat and humidity as of Thursday. Summer is with us still.
Yeah, and it's going to be August. Thanks for joining us for ABC 6 News at Noon. The news continues first at 4. We'll see you there.
Closed captioning brought to you by
Hope Real Estate.